Hello everyone, my name is Julia. Welcome to another IonTOF tutorial. In the last video, we have learned how to perform MVSA calculations on images in SurfaceLab, and today I would like to show you the results. For our experiment, we have prepared ink strokes in four different colors on filter paper and acquired a stage scan of the area. The purpose of the analysis was to find mass intervals which reveal the chemical differences between the colors with the help of multivariate curve resolution. The goal of MCR is to resolve spectra from chemical mixtures present in a sample into contributions from the individual components making up the mixtures. In other words, MCR seeks to uncover and describe the underlying chemistry. In order to guide the solution process towards those that are physically plausible, it is often implemented with alternating least squares procedures that include physically inspired constraints like non-negativity of concentrations and mass spectra. This makes the MCR results similar to SIMS results and therefore easier to interpret. In an MCR calculation, the order of the factors is arbitrary, unless to PCA. Please watch our MVSA Part 1 video in order to see how to perform the MCR calculation. In this video, we will look at the results. In the image program, the score images are given in the image stockpile. They can be added to the worksheet and processed like a standard image resulting from a mass interval. The score images describe the relationship between the pixels as described by the factors. The loading plots of the MVSA results will be displayed in the spectrum program. Loadings describe how the variables, which means the mass intervals, relate to the factors. The loadings show which mass intervals are responsible for the differences seen in the score images. High loading values indicate that the mass interval strongly influences the component. Loadings close to zero indicate that the variable has a weak influence to the component. For a further interpretation, the loadings have to be looked at together with the score images in the spectrum program. The loading plot shows that, for example, mass 120 has a high contribution to factor 1. The comparison of the score image here in the middle and the secondary ion image on the left shows that they do match perfectly. The third plot here on the right shows the loadings of the selected mass interval for all other MVSA factors and is an indication of the uniqueness of the contribution of mass interval 120 to factor 1. It has nearly no contributions to other factors. Also, mass 45 has a high contribution to factor 1. The comparison of the score image and the ion image shows that they do not match perfectly, because this mass interval has also contributions to other factors, especially factor 4. This is visualized in the third plot on the right. In the peak list, you may also sort the intervals along their loadings by clicking onto the area table header. This allows a quick access to the most significant masses for the selected MVSA factor. To tag mass intervals for further analysis, the mass intervals subsets function is perfect. For the selected factor, use the respective subset from the list, select the masses of interest from the loadings plot or the peak list, and press V to add the mass interval to the subset. The interval subsets are then applied to the original data view. In the image program, each mass interval subset is displayed as individual tab in the image stockpile. In the end, with a combination of MCR and mass interval subsets, I was able to find mass intervals representing the different inks very quickly. I hope you enjoyed this video and have some fun playing around with the new MVSA feature. My name is Julia. Thank you for watching and goodbye.